foreign policy requires that our government tax us to the hilt, and then they borrow to the hilt, and then they print the money, and then they go over and they blow up bridges with our money, which drains our economy. At the same time, then we feel obligated that we have to rebuild the bridges that we blew up. What we need to do is quit the blowing up and the building of other people's bridges and build and take care of our own bridges here at home. You know, in the last couple of years, we have been involved in building a new embassy for Iraq. You know, there's hints at times from the administration and others that say, well, we don't want to be there permanently. But we know what's behind the goal of having 14 permanent air bases and army posts in Iraq. At the same time, we as taxpayers have been asked to pay $1 billion to build an embassy in Baghdad, the biggest in the world, biggest the Vatican. Now, does that show a sign that we don't have intention of running their country? It makes no sense whatsoever. But what we need to do is just look to our Constitution. The Constitution does not give us authority. There's no authority to do this. The advice of the founders was very correct. It said stay out of entangling alliances. Trade with people, be diplomatic with people, be friends with people. Sure, there's going to be a lot of people in the world that have shortcomings, but we have our own, our obligations to take care of our own shortcomings. Now, at the height of the Cold War, there were decisions made, which I think were proper at the time, to at least talk to the Chinese and the Soviets. And that, of course, has led to the end of the Cold War, and we didn't have to fight. If we could talk to Khrushchev and Mao Zedong in China and work out a better relationship, don't you think we could at least have diplomatic relations with Cuba? And and for that matter, why can't we at least talk to the Iranians? Why do we have to say... Early on in one of the debates, it came up with what our options might be for the Iranians. And the other candidates were not even willing to take off the table a nuclear first strike. That makes no sense whatsoever. But what will bring it to an end is the finances, because that's the way it usually ends, unless we can reverse the trend. We can end it differently. We can end it with common sense and following the law. But if we continue to do this, it will be ending with a financial crisis, and that is what the devaluation of the dollar is telling us today. Every single day we see the dollar keep slipping and slipping and slipping. There are some in Washington who actually advocate a weak dollar. Now that makes a whole lot of sense to me. We all have dollars, we're forced to use dollars. If you try to use gold, they're liable to put us in jail for doing it. Since we hold dollars, we work for dollars, and then our government's position is deliberately to devalue the dollar, are they on our side or not? No. So what we need to do is, of course, think about the monetary system. The monetary system has been corrupted. The monetary system is unconstitutional. It doesn't exist anymore. Central bank. Quickly thereafter, Hamilton established a national bank, and of course, Thomas Jefferson came along and got rid of it. And then, of course, the second national bank came along, and Andrew Jackson, another gold standard guy, got rid of that bank, too. military industrial establishment, the entire establishment, are against us. They're against the people because they use that system to undermine us through this sinister method of taxation, which is the inflation tax, by just creating money out of thin air. And it has to stop before it brings us down as a great nation. And we need to do it right now. If we had constitutional government, then everybody knows my position on that. I get asked frequently by the media, and they say, well, you want to get rid of the income tax, that's fine. But what are you going to replace it with? How about nothing? Now, we should repeal the 16th Amendment and get rid of the IRS and also get rid of the functions. Functions that we have in government that we don't need and are unconstitutional. You don't need an income tax if we had constitutional government. And that's what we should start. But in the transition, there are certainly ways you can pick priorities, and I think that we should do that because we can't cut off every single unconstitutional program in 1 week. It might take a month or two. But no, we don't. Tragically, we have created a whole generation or two totally dependent on government for their retirement benefits, on medical benefits, and besides, they were promised these benefits back. And even though the real corruption was that this money has been spent, we have to do our very best to take care of those people who have become dependent. And there's a way to do that, but it has to be dealt with in light of changing our foreign policy. We can save enough money to take care of our needs here at home. We can have a stronger national defense by doing this. We can lessen the threat of terrorism in this country. We can restore soundness to our economy. We can balance our budget if we're willing to do that. But if the people of this country want to maintain the growth of the welfare state as it is currently growing, and they want to maintain this silly notion of policing the world, we can't do it. That is why this campaign is so important, that our numbers continue to grow, that we have a good showing on next Tuesday, not only in Colorado, but around the country. Because it is that showing that will tell the people of this country that we demand and insist on a change of policy and not waiting for any catastrophic event. That is what has happened so often. Inflation in Germany, ushering in a military fascist dictatorship that played havoc for the world for decades. So we have to prevent this from happening because economic turmoil leads to political turmoil. And it also offers an opportunity for governments to come in and use it as an excuse to have even stronger government. What we need to do is make our case, and it's up to us to make our case, for the reason that less government is what is necessary, not more government.